Oh, hey, didn't see you there. I was too busy studying my evolution notes for the AP Biology exam. I will talk about six main points. Lamarck and Darwin, the four major modes of evolution, the types of selection, evolutionary patterns, Hardy-Weinberg, and we're gonna talk about the evidence we have for evolution.
But evolution is boring.
Now when I'm done teaching you, what exactly is evolution? Evolution is the genetic change in a population of organisms that leads to progressive change from simple to complex. Now this sounds hard now, but I'm gonna make it go from complex to simple!
Wasn't evolution proposed by Darwin or something?
Yes, but not at first. The first proposed the theory of evolution was Mr. John Baptiste Lamarck. His theory was that evolution took place by the inheritance of acquired characteristics. This is best explained through giraffes, which he studied. Lamarck said that the giraffes' ancestors started out with short necks, and as they stretched to eat the leaves on the trees, their necks just grew longer, and that trait was passed to their giraffe babies.
Giraffes? Really?
Yes, giraffes. Darwin, however, said that the giraffes had different length necks due to genetic differences. And the giraffes with the longer necks survived long enough to where they could reproduce and produce long-necked babies. Talk about our next subject, the four major modes of evolution. I give the floor to my teaching assistant, Miss Dunning.
Hello, I am Miss Dunning, and today we will be discussing the four major modes of evolution. You have genetic drift, gene flow, mutation, and natural selection.
This is gonna put me to sleep.
We don't need your silly comments in here. Anyway, the first major mode of evolution is genetic drift, which is a change in allele frequency due to a change in events.
This can be caused by natural causes such as mountains or rivers or volcanoes.
Our second major mode of evolution is gene flow, which is a change in allele frequency as genes from one population are put into another. This is the result of animals and plants being brought... Are you sleeping in my classroom?
There's no sleeping in my classroom! I'm not sleeping.
And no hats.
Disruption, folks.
Anyway, our third major mode of evolution is mutation, which is the changes in allele frequency when they are random. And our final major mode of evolution is, drum roll please! The final major mode of evolution is natural selection, which is when one organism that is surviving is better than another based on a trait.
Oh, good thing we're done. Now I can take a nap again.
Unfortunately for you, you will not be getting your nap time because there are three conditions to natural selection. Number one is variation, which is when a population must exhibit phenotype variance and the differences must be present. Number two, heritability, which is when the parents must be able to pass their traits to their offspring. Number three, differential reproductive success, which is how many offspring you produce that survive relative to how many the other individuals produce.
Guess who?
Don't worry, kids, I'm back.
Are you kidding me? This one's even worse.
Okay. Our next point is the types of selection. There are three types of selection. You have directional, stabilizing, and disruptive.
Directional selection acts to eliminate one extreme. It often occurs in nature when the environment changes. Stabilizing selection acts to eliminate both extremes. It makes intermediate traits more common by eliminating the extremes. Disruptive selection acts to eliminate intermediate types.
Oh my god, when is this class period gonna end? I wanna go see my boyfriend.
What boyfriend?
I'm not a diva. I will have you know, I do in fact have...
That's enough.
Our next topic is evolutionary patterns. You have four main... You have coevolution, convergent evolution, divergent evolution, and parallel evolution.
I mean, like the movie? That was such a good movie. Like, oh my god.
Not like the movie. First evolutionary pattern is coevolution. This is the mutual evolution between two species. This is your standard predator-prey relationship. Another evolutionary pattern is convergent evolution. That is when two unrelated species evolve in a way that they're more similar. Next, you have divergent evolution. This is two related species evolve so that they are less similar. Lastly, we have parallel evolution. That is similar evolutionary changes occurring in two species, unrelated or not. Any questions?
I definitely have a question. Which of the Divergent books is your favorite? Because mine is definitely the first one.
Let's move on. Next we have projects on Hardy Weinberg. First project is Vanessa.
Do I like start now? Okay. So I did my project on the Hardy-Weinberg principle. The Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium is when proportions of genotypes do not change a population if, number one, no mutation takes place. Number two, no genes are transferred to or from other sources, so like no immigration or emigration takes place. Number three, random mating is occurring. Number four, the population size is very large. Number five, no selection occurs. H-W principle can be written as an equation. Not that anyone would ever use that. It's used to calculate allele frequencies, and for two alleles, P and Q, P equals B for black coat color because black matches your outfits better. And a black hat is two capital B's, or B and a lowercase b. And Q equals lowercase b for white coat color, because white does not match as well as black does. And white cats are two lowercase b's. And the equation is P2 plus 2PQ plus Q2 equals 1. And two big b's plus big b little b plus two little b's is 1. And this is equivalent. So if all five assumptions for equilibrium are true, allele and genotype frequencies do not change from one generation to the next. So in like reality, most populations will not meet like all five assumptions. So you have to like look for changes in the like frequency.
That's your project.
Yeah.
That PowerPoint belongs to my teacher friend, Ms. Geidner.
And your point is?
You get an F. Go to the principal's office. The only thing she didn't include in that PowerPoint was the Hardy-Weinberg conditions. And there's our no mutations, no gene flow, no genetic drift, no natural selection, and random mating must take place. We have a guest speaker here to talk to you about the evidence for evolution, who is a professor at Berkeley.
Hello. Today we are going to talk about the evidence for evolution. Number one, homologous structures, which are traits that are similar because they evolved from a common ancestor. Number two, embryology. Embryos are similar in many stages. And then lastly, we have vestigial structures, which are carried characteristics that were once useful but aren't anymore.
Thank you, Professor. Now, we learned many things in this lesson on evolution. We learned about Lambrecht and the giraffes. We learned about Darwin and how his theory of evolution was the right one. We also learned the four major modes of evolution being genetic drift, gene flow, mutations, and natural selection. We also learned the types of selection being directional, stabilizing, or disruptive. We also learned the evolutionary patterns, which were coevolution, convergent, divergent, and parallel. We learned about Hardy-Weinberg and the assumptions and conditions that go with it. And last, we learned the evidence to explain evolution. And because of this lesson, you will get every single question related to evolution right on the AP Biology exam. I'm out!
Yes,
I'm here,
Kelly!
I was too busy studying my evolution notes for my AP Biology exam! Parallel evolution. This is when similar evolutionary changes!
Ugh, I hate misunderstanding.
Number two, Herodipity?
Yes, I love me some Theo James.
Everything is grand. I got the whole wide world in the palm of my hand. Everything is perfect. It's all in your place.
Why I'm so boring.
Smile off my face. Doing a video. Like a rose. With someone to paint. I'm reading it.
Life's a piece of cake. With someone to pedal, someone to break. Life is full of glee. With someone to saw, someone to see. Life's a happy song.
Adoptions or
adoptions?
Okay.
Why are you talking funny, Mises?
Everything that I need.
In this video. Right in front of me. Thank you, Freshers.
Close up. Close up time!